Next one is interesting astronomical fact. First, let's see what is eclipse. Eclipse is nothing but opaque bodies cast shadow when they block light. Here, two main types of eclipse can be observed from the Earth. One is lunar, another one is solar eclipse. Before understanding the types of eclipse, you should know the some terms. The term is umbra. Umbra is nothing but inner region of shadow. Next one is penumbra. Penumbra is nothing but outer region of shadow. First, let's see solar eclipse. Solar eclipse is nothing but a solar eclipse occur when the moon comes in between the sun and the earth. Next one is lunar eclipse. Lunar eclipse is nothing but when the earth comes in between the sun and the moon. It blocks the sunlight and casts a large shadow on the moon. Next one is when the earth shadow covers the complete disk of the moon, it's called total lunar eclipse. When it partially covers the disk of the moon, it's called partial lunar eclipse. Lunar eclipse lasts from a few minutes to a few hours. It occurs only on a full moon night when the earth and moon are in a direct line with the sun. When the moon is inside the umbra shadow, it appears red in color. As soon as the moon exits from the umbra shadow, it appears its crescent shape. Next one is umbra disk radius. This is umbra disk radius. From this diagram, we will find the apparent radius of the earth, umbra, shadow and moon. And then the ratio of these radii can be calculated. So first, the apparent radius of the earth, umbra, shadow R is equal to the value is 13.2 centimeter. Next, the apparent moon radius is RM is denoted as apparent radius of moon. Okay, so here RM is equal to the value is 5.15 centimeter. So the ratio of the radius is RS divided by RM is equal to 13.2 divided by 5.15. After the simplification, the result is RS divided by RM is equal to 2.56. So now I want to calculate the radius of the earth umbra shadow RS. So here RS is equal to 2.56 into RM. So this is meaning what? The radius of the earth umbra shadow, which is equal to 2.56 time of the radius of the moon. So here the radius of the moon value is RM is equal to 1737 kilometer. So this value are applied in this equation. So here R is equal to 2.56 into 1737 kilometer. So after the multiplication, the result is 4446 kilometer. So this is radius of earth umbra shadow. Next, the correct radius is R equal to 46110 kilometer. So I will calculate the percentage error in the calculation. So how will you calculate the percentage of error? The percentage of error is nothing but the difference between the true value and measured value. So here true value is 4610 minus measured value what? 4446 divided by the original value 46110 into 100. So here after the simplification, the final result is 3.5%. So this is the percentage error in the calculation. Why don't we have a solar or lunar eclipse every month? Because the moon orbit wobbles, changing the placement of its shadow. That is, the moon orbit is tilted 5 degrees with respect to the earth orbit. Sometimes the shadow is too high above the earth. Sometimes the shadow is too low
to have an eclipse, it must be just right. Like this. Next one is, why do we have season on Earth? Because of the rotation of Earth around the Sun with 23.5 degree tilt. Due to this 23.5 degree tilt, the northern hemisphere tilted towards the Sun. That is, longer days receive more of the sun rays. The sunlight hit more directly. At June month, the northern hemisphere towards the sun, so that's why the northern hemisphere experience summer, southern experience winter. At December month, the northern hemisphere away from the sun, so it is experience winter, southern experience summer. At December 21, June 21, both are experience longer day. At both side of pole region experience the length of the day is equal to length of the night. It occurs North Pole at March 21 and South Pole as at September 23. Next one is stars' apparent motion and spinning of the Earth. How the Earth spinning motion can be proved by observing star position over a night. Due to the Earth spinning motion, the stars in the sky appear to move in a circular motion about a pole star.